disappear into that vile ruin. And now the sky, the light, the very land limps as a leper. Somehow, whether through deliberate act or accident, you've caused this. Now we all suffer your consequences. Different good, different bad. We now know upon which side the coin has fallen.
At the risk of sounding maudlin, life has held only disappointment for me. But death, well, we seem to understand each other. And so death is the patron of my art. I have learned much from her in the grave and quiet lands. The crafting of wand and dagger, stave and focus. Tools of nightmare that I will strive to perfect with time and experience, and that I'm willing to share with you for a price. Seek me in the wild lands, exile. The darkness is coming, and we of like mind need to prepare. You? I was beginning to worry that you'd forgotten to brew. But there you are, in and out, like a good little lifer. And that reminds me, I've a few tools on hand that might help you sustain that breathing habit of yours. Care to take a look?
Good to see you alive and well, Kala. I've been thinking about you and what else we might be able to do for each other. I've learned to make do with what's at hand in Rayclast. Nowadays, if it shoots, then I know how to make it shoot faster, straighter, and harder. If you're open to a little trading, I can find you a thing or two that'll help you get the drop on even the nastiest of corrupted vermin out there. You know what, Kala? We need to make sure you're properly equipped for the hunt. I've picked up a few things while I've been roaming the wilds, and I've been doing a bit of fletching and bowcrafting when I can. Have a look and see if anything takes your fancy.
What has happened? Did the world not rise from its sleep? How do we wake it up? Please, what should we do? Her fur, her skin, reminds me of biting winter. I call her Snow Fiend. I saw her one night, followed her to a cave in the old fields to the east. Listened to her howl at the stars. A sad, sad sound. The beast is hurt inside.
I dreamed this. A vast creature. A thing of shadow. I saw it escape from a black prison and climb a man-crafted mountain, drifting up its four sheer sides like the mist that reaches for the clouds. It gathered at the peak of that mountain, and ate the heart from the sun. You smell of that black mist and something else. Guilt. That is it, yes. Guilt is a strong illness. It gnaws at the spirit until there is nothing left, until you are one of the walking corpses. You want a cure? Find the man-crafted mountain, send the shadow home, and tell the monster to take your guilt with it.
This twisting of our surroundings, it's happened before. Melagaro conjured up a creature of the purest, darkest thaumaturgy. How and from where his explanations make no sense to a sane mind. So unless you wish to aspire to a reputation like Piety's, find a way to dispatch that thaumaturgical creature. The longer it resides in Rayclass, the more twisted this land will become.
For all of her strange ways, I've learned not to discount Yina's more vivid dreams. She's in tune with this land in ways I find difficult to comprehend. As to this man-crafted mountain she describes, I have seen only one structure of its like. Stumbled across sketches in the Theopolis archives, a piece of Val engineering, pyramidal in architecture. According to those documents, the pyramid lies north of the Frisian forest, buried beneath the mantle upon which Sarn rests. I have no idea whether it still exists, or ever existed for that matter. Still, considering the current circumstances, there isn't much to lose in the search, is there?
This world gets all bent out of shape, and suddenly here you are. Doesn't take a genius to add that one up. I'm the kind that cleans up his own messes. What kind are you?
Like I figured, first time I saw you. You're trouble, and trouble don't play nice with others. Guess what? I'm a bit troubled myself.
Beast of burden. beast of burden.
On this day, the second Sclato of Verusi, 1334 IC, the Army of Purity remembers its most devout and beloved servant, Archbishop Geoffrey of Frisia. As spoken by Geoffrey, only will and truth can prevail over the evil of our own kin. High Templar Vol, Commander of the Army of Purity.
House of Faith, falling to desecration. Beast of burden.
I am no beast of burden. I am no beast of burden.
Fear gnaws at the entrails of the faithful and the faithless alike. Fear of the unknown, fear of the future. An empire requires leadership that can assuage those fears through example, through wisdom, through strength. An emperor lights the way through the darkened caverns of uncertainty. Fear gnaws at the entrails of the faithful and the faithless alike. Fear of the unknown, fear of the future. An empire requires leadership that can assuage those fears through example, through wisdom, through strength. Emperor lights the way through the darkened caverns of uncertainty.
I am no beast of burden. beast of burden. I am no beast of burden.
You are Dream Tender, my new name for you. Badness is everywhere around us. You bring us something good. Now, I promise to share. Let us awaken the spirit, bring even more good into this life.
First I thought you brave, then a fool for seeking out Mirvale. Fall in love with death. Now, I don't know. The coast is ours, thanks to you. But please, keep one thing in mind for me. What have you become that even nightmares fear you?
quite the lady killer, aren't you? That singing squid didn't stand a chance. Knew it from the first time I saw those sharp peepers of yours. Pirates notwithstanding, I thank you on behalf of all the fallen brethren of the Bay of Song. Now that the final cadence has been played, no one need remember the Bay of Song.
A stranger like no other faced the wall of the Umbra, opened a pass in a sorry land, gave some hope to a sorry band of exiles and death-soaked castaways, a chance at life on a brand new day.
There, thought you deserved one of my finest poems, written to commemorate such a mighty feat. Oh, and this, and keeping it for a very special occasion. Consider yourself just such an occasion.
But one purpose in life now. Defend the last vestiges of faith in this godforsaken land. Well, can't be completely godforsaken. He sent you and me here today. Now, I've a few trinkets lying about that might be of use to you. Adornments imbued with what little faith I can muster in this accursed place. That said, the more corruption we smite, the more faithful I'm likely to be feeling. I can make some damn fine baubles when my divine ire is up. Meantime, let me know if any of my current pieces catch your eye. Ah, God has delivered you to me, and as always, his timing is divine. I've just put the finishing touches on a few baubles. Dripping with faith they are, brimful. Have a wee look and let me know what you think.
Think it possible? All these souls Mervale and her brood have consumed over the years. You've done right by those that are dead, by those who still live. Times like these, I'm reminded that I'm a man of action. Yes. The first roast boar's on me, my friend. Ness is the best of us, not one of Dominus's exiles, a wreck survivor. She keeps us from losing what's left of our minds. Salem's sweet tongue sang it right. The fairest flowers bloom in the foulest places. The walls of this old ruin, lion eyes watch. Defensible enough with a few stout, well-armed veterans. But what have I got? Starving exiles with driftwood clubs and rusted dirks.
You help us, and we help you. Yes?
Beast of burden.
The white beast's spirit is at rest. No more pain. Take this in thanks from me and from the suffering animal that you have helped. Iremir was a wise man in Oria. He is our wise man now. Hear him. You will learn much. If you do not hear, you will likely die.
This is neither the time nor the place.